So this is in Bern here, Switzerland, the capital of Switzerland. Here it says Anna Feodorowna. She was married with the brother of a Russian Tsar, the Tsar Alexander I. But she got fed up with the climate in Russia, maybe the political climate, but I supposedly it was too cold, so she came here to Bern in Switzerland, and before it was a monastery. But her real name is not Feodorowna. Her real name was Juliane von Sachsen-Coburg. So this is where she lived. Yeah. Pharaonic stuff here. And well, who knows what has been there. It's gone, but something, you know. It all belonged to her. And this is where the Russian embassy is now. You know, it's still the pharaohocracy ruling. You know, the embassy, the politicians. It never ever changed, you know. And Juliane von Sachsen-Coburg, you know, like the English royal family, she was the niece of Queen Victoria of England, you know. They just come here and change their names, and afterwards she got the money of Tsar Alexander, you know, to buy this and to live here and to have a nice life and all this. It really is a nice place. He's next to the River Aar right here. So while the Russian people were starving and their children dying, Juliane von Sachsen-Coburg, a German aristocrat, married to the Russian Tsars and to the brother of Tsar Alexander I, and a niece of the English royal family, you know, it's all the same. They just got the money from the people while children were starving. So that was just before the Russian Revolution, really. She died 1840 here. So let's have a look at the embassy then. So Switzerland is a real, Octogon is a really important part of it all.
And this is how it looked like before. Oh, there's even a sun hieroglyph in it. There it is, a fish and a sun hieroglyph. Or is it a fish?
So here again, the lion. It's not an animal that ever was here in Europe, in Switzerland here. It's the symbol of the royalty, the royal bloodline of the pharaohocracy. Which the European aristocracy, they took over of the pharaohs. And this looks like papyrus. It does, sort of. A river Nile. And there's a funny door. It looks like the round circles the Jews had to wear in the Middle Ages and in Muslim countries. The yellow round circles. I mean, it all has a meaning. There are four of them. Two crosses here. Yeah. There's another line at the other side. Look at the mouth. So on the other side of the house is a sun hieroglyph all over. The pharaohocracy in castles in the Middle Ages, they have this a lot. You know, they are the enemy of mankind. So most certainly the descendants of these ones are living here. So now I probably won't see anything here, but I'll probably see that later when I look at the video. What is in here? Looks like a bunch of sixes. What's that? Ooh, sort of a voodoo stuff, eh? Uh, Look, there's some pharaonic voodoo here. It's a sort of a reptilian coming out of the out of her stomach here, from the back. I don't know what that is. Look at it. It's like on the 50 francs franc bill, the money bill of the Swiss. Look at that. Yeah, some Swiss voodoo. What is this? Probably burning things here. Some real weird stuff coming out of the back here. That's weird, man. Oh yeah, look at the arms. It's a reptilian coming out of the back. See? You see? This is Switzerland, folks. It's the home of evil. The pharaohs.
So this creature crawling out of the back of a human being is the very same creature we can see here on the Swiss 50 francs bill. Here where the high nobility, this is not the low nobility, where the descendants of Juliane von Sachsen-Coburg, Saxe-Coburg-Gotha, you know, like the English royal house. Real funny things going on here in the land of hatred, Octogon. And this reptilian crawling out of the back of a human being, even has these three fingers or three-toed hands, which are quite typical for reptilians, and well, you can see it on a chicken, you know. So why on earth is it, would a normal human being make something like this, you know? And this is also the reason why they, a lot of Masonic and hidden forces, they do the Masonic M gesture, which I'll show it to you now. Well, we can see it here too on some Babylonian stuff. You know, the typical three fingers as this thing crawling out of the back of a human being in Octogon, the home of the devil, Switzerland. It's probably Semiramis. Nice stuff, eh? And even human beings have it sometimes related to some former events or mixtures which is in their DNA and coming back, like sometimes as a regression. And some more, here we can see the M sign. Yeah, there's a lot of artists, politicians, and most of it all the aristocracy, or let's say the fair aristocracy, doing these sort of things. It's in their DNA. And sometimes, you know, this is called Mendel's laws. Sometimes it just comes back. And this is why this lovely lady here is doing the M sign as well, you know. It's also giving two V's, like in Uppies, the protection of the pharaonic empire. So this is Ren Bedok. And in France, La Reine Pédoc, she really had 1 or 2 feet like this. And she was very much related to a little people like Le Cagot. This one apparently really existed. Of course, it's the fair aristocracy. And now they're the ones in power. That says La Reine Pédoc, the Queen of Pédoc. It's etymologically of pied, doigt, and doigt, is a or pas de doigt, it is a goose, so it means goose foot, and she was the queen of the goose foot. So here's the Fleur d'Alys. It's all the fair aristocracy. So this is La Reine Pédoc, who really existed. So that says the Queen Pédoc. It's an old book. And the Queen of Pedoc, the queen with the goose foot, she was very much related with a very special tribe of people. There were over 1 million in France. It's called Les Cagots. And you can see they have the leopard sign of the goose foot or the reptilian foot on their chests. This is a very old drawing from France. I already showed you this. Even one of Napoleon's generals, he was a Cagot. And, well, there are even some pictures of them made in the 50s. And so this is why this three-finger reptilian, it has three fingers crawling out of the back. Here you can see it, the three fingers. Typical reptilian sign. They're all wearing it here in the Middle Ages. And these people, the cargo, they were missing some things in their organs, and they could only live in the mountains, Switzerland, you know, and here in the south of France in the Pyrenees, but they probably made it to Switzerland. So here, for example, is a picture of a cagotte. So that's the female with an E. So if you want to look it up, it's only without an E. Yeah, there were millions of them. Now they're probably mixed and went to Switzerland. So here's some old people from history doing the M sign. I just call it the M sign, but it is in fact Le Pédoc. The goose foot or the reptilian foot. I don't know who that is. Some English bloke, I think. Here the Pope giving the M sign. Or the old Pope. A Mason doing the M sign. And who is this doing the M sign? I saw this guy before somewhere. Who is that again? Oh yes, of course, he's doing the M sign as well, Mr. Mason. And another Mason doing the M sign. Hello, you traitor. Another M sign, this is Joseph Smith, who invented the Mormons. Hello, Mr. Mormon. Well, we all know this fella here. Hello. And this is Martin Luther doing the M sign. The guy who invented the Protestants. Only he was part of the nobility, just as his wife, Katharina von Bora. All nobility, aristocracy, just as this princess of the high nobility in Bern, Switzerland. And he invented the Protestants, you know, the Protestant movement. Only to put people up against each other and kill the Germans by the Swiss mercenaries, by the way. And by a difference in religion, race, color of skin, or ideology, like communism against fascism. They're just, their business is to put people up against each other. So he too is doing the M sign. And here's the monument for Martin Luther. An obelisk, which is a symbol of the pharaoh domination, and so he's part of them. Oh, he was an aristocrat. So look at this picture here. I'm going to show another picture of it. So he's part of the gang, really. So here it is again, together with his wife von Bora. They're all nobility, pretending to be a monk. Even their children. What a monk, eh? More like a monk-y. And this guy hated the Jews very, very, very much. He even wrote a lot of things about it. As the whole of the aristocracy, they hate the Jews. You know, look at the World War II. They were all von in the SS, killing Jews. And, well, they are the pharaohs. I mean, that's logical, isn't it? The pharaohs. Of course, the pharaohs hate the Jews. There's nothing new. And they are the pharistocracy here in Europe. Pretending to be monks and still doing the same thing. Nothing has changed, really. So this is the official Apis hieroglyph, just as the M symbol forming two V's. Here the two upside down V's, just as is in this old French car here, which is still being made today. And it is a symbol of Apis, the bull, and this is the symbol, the symbolizes the protection of the royal pharaonic empire. And this is, to my opinion, one of the reasons that they give the M symbol. Of course, the pharaohs, it's all related, and the aristocracy and the Freemasons, it's all one thing, it's all related. And there might be a reptilian thing in it as well. They are so different from us, just as the Swiss are so different from other human beings. Very, very different. So here the two V's, just as in the M symbol. And this is the old French car, still being made today. And in those days, the means of transport was a bull as well. Yeah, this is, it looks like a bull. Look at the two eyes here. It looks like a bull. Oh, there. The French bull, the pharaonic bull. So the M symbol is also giving these two V's, and one of the V's is of course the Templar symbol, as they also protect the Egypt and the royal, the aristocracy and the royal pharaohs of Egypt. It's all related. The bull is a symbol of the protection of the and that's why a lot of police forces, they have it in their logos, armies, because it protects the Egypt and the pharaohs. The Templars did as well, 1V, etc, etc. So here we can see a painting of Anna Feodorowna, as in feudal, Feodorowna, you see, of Russia. And her real name was Juliana von Sachsen-Coburg, and she's giving the hand sign, the Masonic M, as people call it, but it's actually Piedok, Pidok, like in the Queen of Pidok, and which is a sign of the reptilians. But it's also forming two V's, like in the Apis pharaonic symbol, which is the symbol of the protection of the pharaonic empire. Which is the two V's on top of each other. So it says Anna Feodorowna, there, living in Switzerland.
Now there's the grail. Means our blood is here, our descendants are here. Some more reptilians on it, or what is it? And this is the house of Anna Feodorowna, which was not her name. Her name was Juliana von Sachsen-Coburg. A niece of Queen Victoria. And we all saw the reptilian coming out of the back, didn't we? The pharaohs in Switzerland, related to the English Windsors or Sachsen-Coburg, married to the Russians. Who were in fact Germans living in Switzerland. No, well, not real Germans. The old bloody pharaohs they are. Oh, so this is the grail next to the house. That means our seed is here. Well, you can see there, all the little babies here. Yeah. They're here, all right. This is the... Yeah. So. Oh, that's quite hard. Our seed is here. There it is. That's what it means. This is sort of a vesica paecis, you know, we stick together. All the rings, like the Audi car and the Olympic Games. I don't know what sort of a leaf that is. It all has a meaning. What kind of bird is that? Probably an ibis bird of the pharaohs. It had to do with their descendants, I think, the ibis bird. Well, okay. And here again, of course, here's their house. The descendants are living here under other names, you know, they're incognito-like, but they're still the same. Of course it is. It's a very special hill. I've been doing some evil things and I can sense it. So, and this here is Octogon. Of course, octagonal. The sign of the Templars. It's all here. Everything is next to the building. Just look around, it is the aristocracy. They're the ones who are doing it all to us. And we are their slaves. With the lions and grails and... So this is the Russian embassy, and Marco, that was the Swiss guy, one of those Greenpeace fellows, who was acting like for Greenpeace, sort of, for the New World Order against Russia. So this is all the Russian embassy. This is full of cameras. And of course, next to it, there's the Russian flag. Yeah. I think it's white, blue, and red. And there is the house of Anna Feodorowna, who was not that, but who was Juliane von Sachsen-Coburg, just right next to it. So, you know, the aristocracy is there. Or, as I know them, the pharaohs. Well, don't you think that this embassy here is not the pharaohs? It's still the same ones here, you know. And here they're coming out, there's a children's playground just here, where the Russians come out and play with the children, you know. So if there's any Muslims who want to drink a cup of tea with them, you know, you can find them here. So the Swiss actually, when it considers one of them, they organize. Here we can see they can organize, and very quickly. They even write these things on the wall here. You know, if it would have been something else, the police would have taken this away. But because it's one of them, they leave it here. But if it's about, you know, immigrants being tortured and stigmatized here in Switzerland, nobody does a thing. And I know this, you know, I've sent them thousands of letters and talked to people. They just laugh in my face. But if it's one of them, you know, they immediately react. Now this is Switzerland, all right. There's another door. So it's all part of the embassy. Look, another door. It's also like a castle. So, you know, this is the aristocracy. You know, nothing has changed. It's just the old world order was the feudal system of the aristocracy, and the new world order is their system of Freemasons and Templars. Because the second son and the third son, they also wanted to have some power. But it's still the aristocracy. It's still Egypt. It's still the pharaohs. Nothing has changed. They just put on another jacket. So there's Anna Feodorovna. There's the river Ara, which sort of represents the Nile for them. There must be an obelisk somewhere, and the water represents Isis, and this is the Russian embassy in Bern. Now, they're all together. It's all the same thing. The aristocracy, the pharaohs are there, and they are there everywhere. So there's the mansion, family of the British royal family, and here's the river Arre. This is what the name is, it's related to the word elves, you know, the fairies, and this is the river here. And if anybody reads German, you can read it. It's even in English. mistletoe, a holy plant for the Celts, next to the pharaohocracy.
So this is what the Elfenau looked like before, and look at the pond, it's not octagonal yet, it's round, because it was a monastery before, and then it was bought by the aristocracy, and they even took the energy, you know, to make it octagonal on purpose. You see, it's round here, as it used to be, it's all on purpose. So it wasn't even octagonal in the first place. So we're not satisfied with it. God knows what they did in there. And there it is again with the River Ari. No chemtrails. Well, here, look here. This is where I spotted the reptilian crawling out of the back of a human being. It's still the... It's their descendants of the high nobility. And then, why the nobility? Why do they, you know, make a picture of a statue on like an altar of a human being, you know, with a reptilian crawling out of his back, with the M sign and all that? Well, you know, why did they get this idea? You think it's a coincidence? Well, and there it is again, the house, the mansion of Anna Feodorowna is on the left-hand side. And, well, the pharaohocracy always chooses the best places for themselves, isn't it? Little paradise in Octogon. So here's the coat of arms of the Saxe-Coburg dynasty, who just had their mansion or palace next to the Russian embassy. Now here we can see the Apis hieroglyph. You have to look at the two white ones, of course. And one of them is the symbol of the Templars. And the pharaohocracy is, in fact, they are more like Muslims with their prearranged marriages and all that. It's all Middle Eastern stuff here with their lions, an animal that never was in Europe. They're not European at all. Europeans don't do pre-arranged marriages, do they now? It's all pharaonic, you know, it's not from here. They're more like Muslims than Europeans. They're not from here. And now they're sitting in the Freemasonry lodges and the politicians. It's still the same pharaohocracy. So this is her in Wikipedia. So this is not the lower nobility, this is not just this is the high nobility, you know, related with the Tsars, the Windsors, which are actually the her next relatives, like the Saxe-Coburg Gotha family. It's all pharaonic. And yeah, she did the Pedoc, the M sign, and her descendants are having a little altar with a reptilian coming out of the back of a human being, the same one they have on the Swiss francs. What charming, isn't it? Charming country, a charming people. And well, Switzerland, Octogon is their base. It always has been. So this woman, she probably couldn't even speak Russian because she was German. Well, of course she went to Switzerland where they speak German. She did. I mean, if she was really German and not just an aristocrat, she would go back to Germany, but she didn't, because Switzerland is pharaonic. Germany is German. The Swiss are not German. The French-speaking Swiss, they're not at all like the French. Oh, no. It's as different as a Japanese with an Eskimo. And the German-speaking part, well, they hate the Germans. They, you know, I know how they treat Germans here. And the Italian, except when they need them, though. And the Italian-speaking Swiss, they're not at all like the Italians. They're more Swiss-German than Italian, I tell you. So, this is their home. When it didn't work out with the Tsar, she went back to the base where she could get protection and spend the rest of her life. making little babies, who nowadays put reptilians in the back of human beings. Evil things going on in the Alps.
Hello, Isis. Look, it's Friday evening. All the fancy people there in their palace. Probably a Freemason gathering. Let's have a closer look, shall we? You want to? Shall I do that? Okay. Probably some upper class pharistocracy with that reptilian thing we just saw, the reptilian coming out of the back of a human being. The upper class here. All have these gatherings, especially like Friday evening, Saturday. Yes, Isis here. This is what they like. Oh, this is little Horus. There's Isis watching him. Yeah. With a pharaonic cloth. No women here would wear that, you know. And he's even sitting on the octagon. Look at this. It's the Horus Matrix. He's sitting on the octagon. And what's he holding? It looks like a canopy. The canopy is a vase where the pharaohs, they put their souls in. So that means we kill the man and, you know, we kill their soul. That's the Horus Matrix. Yeah. That's why we have all the wars. I mean, well, you don't have to guess twice what these people are there. We saw the reptilian before, and the Swiss are so cold, you know, having statues with reptilians coming out of the back. Oh boy. So unfortunately it's getting dark, so you won't be able to see it clearly, but she, I tell you, she's standing on a step pyramid. It's a pyramid with several steps. I forgot the name of that. Look, you see? It's going on several levels. Well, it's hard to see that. I thought she was standing on an oval socket.
Well, there she is again. Where her descendants are having a little altar, you know, with a reptilian crawling out of the back. And with the M sign on the fingers, and
the world domination. And this is octagonal. Some more octagonal stuff. That's part of the it's part of the castle there, the descendants. The castle is just behind here. The descendants of Anna Feodorowna or Juliane von Sachsen-Coburg. Well, we know what Sachsen-Coburg represents, don't we? Hey, we know these people. They're everywhere.